the likeness and image of God. Now let us try to seek for the likeness and image where it is. The likeness is there in what we call the correspondences. In nature, there is light through sun and the moon and the stars. In us, there is the correspondence which we call the power to see. So, the light has its correspondence with the sight in us. And the space is there. The sound principle is there in space. And the power to listen the sound is there in man. Air is there in the form of winds and breezes. The power of respiration is there in man. Like that, from head to foot, you take everything. It is only in the form of correspondences with the wider creation. The bigger creation can be understood as a tree, and you can understand your constitution as its seed. This is how you can understand the likeness of God in man. Then what about the image? Image means reflection. Our body is a reflection of ourselves. By reading the scriptures, we understand we are not our body. Because when we cut our hair or barb and still we can live, then we can very easily understand we are not our hair or barb. The hair or barb are the outgrowths from us into outer existence. Similarly, if the finger is cut by mistake, we can live. Common sense tells us we are not the finger, but we have the finger. Similarly, we have the eye, we have the head, we have the chest. Like that, from head to foot, we have everything, and we are not any one of these. So we have a body, we are not the body. We are different from what we have. So we are is the inner we are. The we have is the outer we have. So the outer is the image of the inner. The we are is the omnipresent in us. The we have is the exterior of the inner presence. The one existence is living in all of us. Just as many little bottles thrown in a river, you find the river existing in all the bottles. The bottles are in the river, but the river is in the bottles. It may appear that every bottle is having a separate quantity of water. Similarly, we may, out of ignorance, believe that we are separately existing, each having a body. Of course, we are permitted to live with this ignorance for many births and live a life of animal individuality. But someday or other, it is inevitable that we should know that only one existence is existing in all these bodies. Like that, the one is whom we call God. And the many are the many bodies. So the many, each of them is created in the likeness and the image of the one. This is how we can understand step by step how God made man in his own image and likeness. And to know the one in everyone, we have an awakening and an awareness into the purest of the existence of us, the existence which is not the body, but the existence which includes the body. for the existence which is not the mind, but which includes the mind. The existence which is not the senses, but which includes the senses also. That one existence is made by us to feel someday or other. We begin to feel the real existence someday or other, but evolution stops halfway in the human being. In the plants and animals and minerals, evolution conducts the whole process, and it is not left unfinished. But in the case of human being, it is different. It is made halfway, and it makes man a creator of his future evolution, and it leaves his evolution with him. So the artist is created with all his paraphernalia, with all his material, and then he is left to create his art. The painter is created with all his colors and canvas, and he is left to paint. Like that, the human evolution is left halfway by nature. It made man a creator on the background of the creator. And it asks the creator to create the remaining part of the evolution. Until we begin to create, it stops there and it waits at our door. And many births and deaths will take place in the meanwhile. But the progress awaits our own stir, our own impulse. Biologically, births and deaths will be taking place, but no progress is gained. Just as a motor car lifted upon jockeys in the workshop, even though the wheels are rotating at a high speed of 120 kilometers an hour, no distance is gained. So the speed is there, the rotation is there, and the burning of the oil is there, but the distance is not gained. Same thing in our case also. We are expected to take the lead. The sculptor is chiseled with all his instruments and stone in the mountain, and then he is asked to make the sculpture. That is the mystery and the miracle of human evolution. And the scriptures reveal us this much. The scriptures ask us to know the purest of our existence, to awaken into the pure I am, and try to know I am not the body. I have a body, I am not a body. I have a mind, I am not a mind. I have knowledge, I am not knowledge. I have intelligence, I am not intelligent. I have strength, I am not strength. I have strength, I am not strength. I am what? The scripture says, I am that I am. That means, don't choose a second word to know the I am. Know that the I am is only I am and not a second thing. So the scripture says, I do not permit a second existence. This is wrongly translated in the Old Testament and said, I, the Lord God, am a jealous God. I do not tolerate you worshipping other gods. This is how scriptures are spoiled through translation. In its Original, it means I am only one. There are no two I ams in two bodies. Only one I am shining through the millions and millions of vehicles. Meditate and use the word only I am. Try to put your mind only upon the meaning of the word I am and receive the enlightenment. Receive the light only through the same source, which is not foreign to you, which is not a second thing to you, which is the I am of you, where the meaning of you will go away and the meaning of I am exists. And it is called self-illumination, which is once again wrongly translated as the burning bush. The original of the expression burning bush is self-illuminating. It is always shining and burning. How do you know that you exist? Because you know. That is self-illumination. Everyone knows that he exists. How? Is it that the father told him that you exist? Or the mother trained him that he exists? Or the teacher in the school teaches him, you exist, you exist, you exist, like that? Every living being, let it be ant or beast or bird or man, knows I exist. Because the same one exists in all these bodies. That's why when man went to the burning bush, the name of the God is given to him. He said, my name is I am that I am. When Moses asks God, what should I tell if the Pharaoh asks me your name? Then God says, there is no your name, there is only my name. There is no his name. Because if we use the word God in third person, it is only a photograph of God and not God. Just as a photograph of an eating dish cannot satiate our hunger, our appetite. Yes. Okay. Yes. No amount of knowledge in third person about God can teach us what God is. It is a process of becoming and not knowing. It is a process which is similar to that of one magnet making another magnet, and not at all the process of teaching magnetism in a classroom. If the teacher places an iron piece on the table, takes the big volume on magnetism and rubs the iron piece with the volume, the iron piece can never become a magnet. So it requires only a magnet and not a lesson on magnet. This is what is transmitted to us through scriptures. And the scriptures have their wonderful symbolism, a few aspects of which I will discuss and make you understand in the following lectures. The highest of all these symbols and the highest of all initiations is to meditate upon the meaning of the word I am. That is the one word which is given in all the scriptures. See, the Christ says, I am the way. In some other place he says, there is no other way. There is only one way. He says, I am life. He says, I am resurrection. In the Bhagavad Gita, he says, I am the omnipresent. And again in the Bhagavad Gita, he says, I am the only one existing in everyone. Take any Upanishad, he says, I am to be known. And take any one of the teachings given by Lord Buddha, how one gets the enlightenment. He says, I am here, the benevolent one. That is the one word which is given through scriptures. And in fact, the word is given by nature in the form of the creation of the many beings. Hence, the creation is called the utterance of the one word. So, tomorrow I will speak and explain some important aspects of the world scriptures. Thank you all for today. Yes. Any relevant questions are always welcome. Yes, that is the question. Then what is it to be explained? I do not understand the problem. Yes, yes, certainly it is our immediate need to do so. It is our immediate need to establish as many triangles as possible with other countries and fill the triangles with consciousness, not only through meditation but also through some work on the physical plane between those countries. If the number of people who work out these triangles becomes more and more, the people who rule and administer also will be among the people who form the triangles. And that will solve the problems. I'll be able to explain this only when I see the English version. Tomorrow I'll be able to go. I think we have a copy of it. Tell him that. Yes, certainly.
Oui.
That is why we make a request that such an idea should be removed. Yes, the idea of superiority, when it is sacrificed, the separateness will not be there. No, every individual, as many individuals as possible, should begin to believe it and work it out. That gradually, yes. Anything we do which is useful to others will increase the light. Bigger individuals, just as we are composed of many cells and corpuscles, nations are composed of millions of human beings. When some cells begin to behave independently in a body, we call it disease. So the same thing happens if it is in a nation. Nations make their own existence, but no individual can create a nation. Nature creates even what we call new nations. Because an individual cannot create a nation though he tries. When a nation is to make its existence, an individual becomes instrumental. So, when there is a new nation making itself manifest, we should understand that it is a new leaf coming out of the tree of humanity. And wherever there is conflict, it is false. Wherever there is progressive or constructive element, it is truth of nature. So just as we behave with other nations, we should behave with the newly formed nations also. Because the idea nation is only psychological and not exactly physical. And it is a necessity created by nature in the human beings to develop through so many dimensions. just as all the fingers are not of the same size. We should understand the total utility required for the five fingers. But if we begin to cut the other fingers according to the one, then there is no use. Similarly, the individuals in any nation should behave according to any one of the scriptures. Then all the nations automatically begin to behave like the fingers. So the differences created by nature are progressive, like the difference in the fingers. And the differences created by man are destructive, and that is proved by war many times. So we should distinguish between the two types of differences, make the proper use of the difference in nature, and eliminate the man-made differences from mind. That is how we should meditate and behave with others. Yes. The best thing is to select a person who is known to you in some other country or nation, and a third person who is known to these two persons in a third country, and begin to communicate thought, and daily at some time or other feel the presence of the other two along with himself, and begin some progressive activity among the three nations. It may be by way of some human service or some business which is of real use to others, or it is by way of teaching something or healing. Then the triangle establishes itself. Then each of these can establish another triangle with two unknown different persons of two other countries. That is how ourselves with our brother Robert Pitt and Mr. Rudolph formed first. We three belong to three different spiritual organizations. The one is the founder of the energy systems parameters,